Hi friends, welcome to Thinkers IAS. This crash course is exclusively for prelims 2020. Only topic which are relevant for prelims 2020 are covered here. It saves your time during the last minute preparation. Please download the PDF study material. Link is provided in the description box below. Today let us begin with All India Tiger Estimate 2018. In India, tiger census is carried out every 4 years. Recent report is Status of Tigers, Co-Predators, Prey and Their Habitat 2018. According to the report, there are 2,967 tigers in 2018 compared to 2,226 in 2014. The 33% rise in tiger numbers is the highest ever recorded between cycles. It is carried out under Project Tiger, a centrally sponsored scheme in 1973 for in-sit conservation of wild tigers in designated tiger reserves. National Tiger Conservation Authority (NTCA). It is a statutory body established in 2006 under Wildlife Protection Act in 1972. This authority oversees the entire tiger-related issues in the country. Maximum entropy models, that is MEGENTA. In some northeastern states with logistical concerns, MAXENT was used, which is based on photos taken within small intensively searched areas to model suitable tiger habitat. This terminology is very important. Please make note of it. Findings of All India Tiger Estimate 2018. Top state MP with the biggest increase from 308 in 2014 to 526. Second is Karnataka with 524 tigers. Habitat loss in tiger occupied area is estimated to be 20% of tiger habitat in 4 years. No tiger was recorded in Buda, West Bengal, Damp in Mizoram and Palamu, Jharkhand tiger reserves. Technologies used in tiger census. First is M-STRIPES, monitoring systems for tigers, intensive protection and ecological status. M-STRIPES. It is a mobile-based application where various data related to tigers in the field are monitored and recorded. CARAT, Camera Trap Data Repository and Analysis Tool. It is image processing software used for organizing and geotagging of photo captures. Please refer these images for more information on tiger census. This is also provided in the PDF. Global Tiger Initiative, that is GTI. It was launched in 2008 as a global alliance of governments, international organizations, civil society, the conservation and scientific communities and the private sector. St. Petersburg Tiger Summit in Russia, 2010. All 13 tiger range countries came together for the first time. TX2 program, its goal was to double the number of wild tigers across their geographical areas. Details of tiger. It is the tiger species native to India. India is home to 80% of global tiger population. Conservation status of tiger, IUCN Red List. Endangered Wildlife Protection Act, Schedule IAN CITES, Appendix 1. Tiger Reserves in News. Pakyar Pakhai Tiger Reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh government is planning to build highway named East-West Industrial Corridor, which includes a 40-kilometer elevated stretch through the core areas of Poho or Pike Tiger Reserve. Amrabad Tiger Reserve, Telangana. Uranium exploration will be conducted in this tiger reserve. It lies in Nallamala Hills that stretch in Mahbub Nagar and Nalgonda districts of Telangana. state butterflies. Tamil Nadu, Tamil Yeoman. Maharashtra, Blue Mormon. Uttarakhand, Common Peacock. Karnataka, Southern Bird Wings. Kerala, Malabar Banded Peacock. India's Starry Dwarf Frog. It is found in Western Ghats. Scientists have named the frog Astrobatrachus curciana for its constellation-like markings and the indigenous people of Kurchiar Mala, the hill range where it was found. The researchers have nicknamed them starry dwarf frogs because they are around the size of an adult's thumb. Now let us look into Chinkara. Chinkara is a species of semi-arid regions. Chinkara survives in the dry habitats and does not require much water for their survival. Conservation status, that is IUCN status, least concern, please remember, it has very least concern. Recently, Karnataka State Board for Wildlife has notified Bukkapatna Chinkara Wildlife Sanctuary in Tumakuru district. The first wildlife sanctuary for Chinkaras was established at Yedahalli in Bagalkote district in Karnataka. Interestingly, Karnataka is home to 3 species out of the 6 species of antelopes in India, including black bucks, 4 horned antelope and chinkaras. Bukkapatna forest area is only documented place in Karnataka for all the 3 antelope species. United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification, that is UNCCD. Recently, 14th Conference of Parties, COP14 of the UNCCD was convened in New Delhi. Please remember, COP of UNCCD and COP of Bonn Convention were held in India last year. UNCCD established in 1994 on International Agreement on Desertification. The convention addresses especially the arid, semi-arid and dry sub-humid areas known as the dry lands, where some of the most vulnerable ecosystems and people can be found. It is one of the 3 Rio conventions adopted by United Nations along with UNFCCC and Convention on Biological Diversity. The permanent secretariat of the convention is located in Bonn, Germany. Publication: it publishes annual report called Global Land Outlook. Please note that the reports and organizations are important for prelims point of view. Please note whatever it is referred in the video, it is also provided in the PDF. Forest Landscape Restoration, that is FLR. India has launched a pilot project to restore degraded forest landscapes in 5 states to enhance the capacity on forest landscape restoration. Announced as part of 14th session of the Conference of the Parties COP14 of UNCCD, India took over COP presidency from China for 2 years. The project will be implemented by National Afforestation and Eco-Development Board NAEB in partnership with the IUCN. In the first phase, the pilot will be conducted in Haryana, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Nagaland and Karnataka. Delhi declaration was adopted as part of UNCCD. It was in which parties expressed commitment for a range of issues including gender and health, ecosystem restoration, taking action on climate change, private sector engagement, peace forest initiative and recovery of 5 million hectares of degraded land in India by 2030. Here, peace forest initiative is an initiative by South Korea to provide a practical platform that will foster international collaboration by demonstrating the value of achieving land degradation neutrality in cross-border post-conflict situations. International Coalition for Action on Sand and Dust Storms, that is SDS. This coalition is a partnership between WMO, UNCCD, UNDP, UNEP, UN Food and Agricultural Organization and the World Health Organization and also World Bank among other institutions. Sand and dust storms, also known as Sirocco, Habub, yellow dust, white storms and the Harmattan. SDS affects approximately 77% of UNCCD country parties or approximately 151 countries. Of these, 45 are classified as SDS source areas. Initiative of Sustainability, Stability and Security, the 3S. This is an initiative of African countries to address migration driven by land degradation. 14 African countries launched the Initiative of Sustainability, Stability and Security, that is 3S. Adapt Now, Global Call for Leadership on Climate Resilience report. It was released at COP14. This report is written by the Global Commission on Adaptation, group of 34 leaders in politics, business and science. It is led by former United Nations Secretary General Ban Ki-moon, Microsoft Corporation founder Bill Gates and former World Bank Chief Executive Kristalin Georgiev. Ramsar Convention. This is the only convention to conserve the wetlands. The convention, signed in 1971 in the Iranian city of Ramsar. This Ramsar Convention maintains Montreux record. This list is a register of wetland sites where changes in ecological character have occurred, are occurring, or are likely to occur as a result of technological developments, pollution, or other human interference. That means wetlands included in this record are under threat from various factors like pollution, encroachment, and other issues. Currently, two Indian lakes, namely Loktak Lake and Keoladio National Park, are in Montreux record. The Ramsar Convention has 6 international organization partners. These include BirdLife International, International Union for Conservation of Nature, that is IUCN, International Water Management Institute, Wetlands International, Worldwide Fund for Nature, that is WWF, World Fowl and Wetlands Trust, WWT. That's it for today. Please subscribe to Thinkers IS for more updates and also please download the PDF study material. This is very useful for the last moment preparation of prelims 2020. The link is provided in the description box below. Thank you.